Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will learn about COBOL subroutines. So this is the agenda. We have call verb. Then we have two different type of calls, like call by reference, call by content. Then we have static call and dynamic call. So we'll start with call verb. Call verb is used to transfer the control from one program to another program. It is used to call a program and do a certain processing. It's like a chain. So we are calling a program from module 1 and we are calling module 2. So here the module 2 is the called module and module 1 is the calling program. So in the module 2, you need to define a linkage section, while in the module 1, you just need to give the parameters which we are passing. So we'll start, like the program that contains the call verb is calling program. The program being called is known as the called program. Calling program execution will halt until the called program finishes the execution. Then exit program statement is used in the called program. It means like in the module 2, that is a called program, you need to give the exit statement. Otherwise, it will never come back to the program 1. It will keep on running in the same program. Or if you code a stop run in the module 2, then it will stop the execution there itself and control will never come back to the main module. So that's the reason, always code exit program in the called module. Then we have call by reference. So if the values of variables in the called program are modified, then their new values will reflect in the calling program. Suppose we are passing two variables and in module 2, which is our called module, the values have been modified. When the control will come back, the modified values will be reflected in the module 1. So that is call by reference. It is the default option. So this is the syntax. Call, here you need to give the module 2 name using variable 1 and variable 2. These are the variables which you want to pass. Now next is call by content. If the values of variables in the called program are modified, then their new values will not reflect in the calling program. So this is the syntax, call subprogram using by content variable 1 and by content variable 2. So what will happen if we are modifying the values of variable 1 and variable 2 in the called module, then their modified values will not reflect in the main module. So now next is static call. Static call occur when a program is compiled with no dynamic compiler option. So it happens when we are compiling it through a JCL, there you need to mention the compile options. A static call program is loaded into the storage at the compile time only. Now next we have dynamic call. Dynamic call occurs when a program is compiled with the dynam or no DLL compiler option. Again, you need to mention this option in the JCL when you are compiling this program. A dynamic call program is loaded into storage at the runtime. So this is all about static call and dynamic call. Now let's see all these functions practically. We will start with calling module. Here we will cover how to call a module from another module. So program 1, this is our calling module, and I will open program 2 as well, that is our called module, so that we can understand the relation between two. It's a typo. 3.4. This program 2 is our called module. Here what I have done is I have declared two variables num1 and num2. We are adding them and storing the results in wsadd. Then we have declared one variable, that is WSPGM, in which we are storing the value of the program name which we will be calling from here. So these are just display statements. Then we have move PGM2 to WSPGM. We need to pass this value to WSPGM, the variable, working storage variable, and then we will be calling this module from WSPGM. Here I have written call WSPGM using WSNum1 and WSNum2. So num1 and num2, we are passing these two variables to the called module. And again, then we are displaying some items. Call verb, as we have discussed this earlier, call verb is used to transfer the control from one program to another program. The program that contains the call verb
is the calling program, and the program being called is the called program. Here, this F9 PGM2, this is our called program. Calling program execution will be on halt until the called program finishes the execution, and exit program statement is used in the called program to transfer the control back. Here you can see in program 2 I haven't used stop run, I have used exit program. If I would have used stop run, the execution would have stopped by now here. So the control will never go back to the calling module. So that's the reason, never code stop run in a called module, always use exit program. Then in called program we have three constraints. We need to declare a linkage section. In linkage section we need to define the elements which we will be using from the calling module. Like in calling module we are passing two elements, WSNum1, WSNum2. Here you need to in linkage section you need to again mention and define the two variables which will be accepting the values from the calling module. So here the data item should not have a value clause. So that's the reason we haven't mentioned any value clause in the linkage section. And the pick clause must be compatible with the variable passed through the calling program. So these are 9 of 2 only. So they are compatible with the calling module, WSNum1 and WSNum2. Then we need to use procedure division using. Here you can see procedure division using. And a list of variables should be passed from the calling module. And the order must be same as mentioned in the call verb. Like here if I have mentioned call WSPGM using WSNum1 and num2. Here you need to mention the same order, LSNum1, LSNum2. Whatever you will write here, the values will come in these two variables in the same order as we have mentioned here in num1 and num2. Then exit program we have already discussed. So this is the statement which is used in the called program to transfer the control back. It must be the last statement of the called program. Then we have two methods by which we can pass the parameters. One is call by reference and one is call by content. Here you can see I haven't mentioned anything, and in the commented line I have mentioned by content. So by default option is by reference, call by reference, which we are using here, call WSPGM using. If you haven't mentioned anything, so by default it will take the call by reference. If the values of variables in the called program are modified, then their new values will reflect in the calling program. So in the called program, this is our called program, we are modifying the values of LSNum1 and LSNum2. If you call it by reference, then these new modified values will be reflected here. That's the reason I have displayed them again. And if you call them by content, then it will pass the values from here, and even if you modify there, the new values will not get back to the calling module. So this is the difference. So it depends from program to program what values you want to pass, and even if you want to modify them, then if you want to modify them and do not want them to be reflected in the calling module, then you can use by calling by content. And if you want to change, if you want that your, if your values are modified, the modified value should come back, then use call by reference. And in this module we have just changed the values of LSNum1, num2. We are displaying it here, and then we are exit program. So first we'll compile this module. We need to change the file program name here. It is referring to file 2, but our program is PGM2. Change all pfile 2 to PGM2. First of all, we'll be executing the, we'll be compiling the program 2. By that time we'll change the values here. Here you can see max is 0, so it's success. Now we'll compile the program one, that is our calling module. By that time we'll ready our GCL to execute this program one. Condition code 0, this is success. Here we have mentioned program 1 only. So we'll be just calling program 1, we'll be executing program 1, and program 2 will be called from program 1 itself. Submit this. These are command lines, don't worry about that. We have used them in previous video. So condition code 0, now we'll go to spool and check the results. Here you can see, first of all we have passed values, this is in calling module, it is showing us the values of num1 is 99, num2 is 72, and when we add them it's 171. After that we had a call statement, so the control passed to the called program. There we have mentioned in called program. Here we have modified the values of ls num1 as 79, ls num2 as 68. Now then we had an exit program. So again it was in calling module, we have written this as a display statement, and here you can see the values have changed because we have used call by reference. So you can see num1 is 79, num2 is 68, previously it was 99 and 72. We have modified their values in the called program, that's the reason they are reflecting back. So we'll see the program once. Here you can see this is our called module. We have modified the values of ls num1 and num2. And just a second, we'll open our module as well. I think I've already opened it. So, okay. So this is program one. Here, the logic started from here in calling module. You can see in calling module, it is displaying num1, num2, adding, and then displaying add. Num1, num2, add. Then we had a call statement. Now we'll go to this program. Here the control came here to the first display statement, that's what it is displaying in call program. Then we are moving 79 to num1 and 68 to num2. We are overriding the values of num1 and num2, then we are displaying them. Here it is displaying num1 is 79, num2 is 68. Then it encountered this exit statement, exit program. After that the control came back to this display statement, again it was saying in calling module, it is saying in calling module. Then we are adding ws num1 to num2 and giving ws add. So the values have been modified of for num1 and num2, and we are displaying num1, num2 and add, and then we had this stop run. So this is an example of call by reference. Now we'll see what will happen in call by content. I will comment out this line and I will uncomment this one. So here we are calling WSPGM using by content num1 and num2. This is a syntax to call by content. We'll exit. We'll compile this because we have changed the logic. This is program one only. We haven't made any change in program two, so we'll be using the same previous load. We'll compile this. So the condition max is 0. Now we'll submit our GCL to execute this program. Condition is 0, it's success. Now we'll check spool. Okay, here we go. Here you can see this num1 is 99, num2 is 72, then ws add was 171. So this was in the calling module, then we have called it using by content. So we change the values here, 79 and 68, but when the control returned back to the calling module, again the values were not modified. Again it is showing 99 and 72 only. So this is an example of call by content. Now we have two different type of calls. Here I will show you the compile JCL, that will be more clear. Here you can see this option, no dynam. So we'll start with two type of calls. We have one static call and we have one dynamic call. Static call occurs when a program is compiled with no dynam option. So this is by default. We haven't mentioned anything in the compiler, so it is taking no dynam by default. A static call program is loaded into storage at the compile time only. Whereas if you mention instead, if I pass dynam instead of no dynam, if I would have passed dynam, then it would be a dynamic call, and it occurs when a program is compiled with dynam and no DLL option. Here you can see this is by default no DLL. So just you need to change this dynamic thing. And in a dynamic called program, it is loaded into storage at the runtime. So this is the difference. In static call, it is loaded at the compile time itself. In the dynamic call, it is loaded at the runtime. So this is the difference between static and dynamic call. Till now, we have covered the basics of COBOL. To give you a start, accessing database and vsim files from COBOL program will be covered in DB2 and vsim videos. Keep on learning.